Well, yet another rain bomb is zeroing in, with Sydney and parts of New South Wales in the crosshairs of heavy rain and storms. This is a live look. Well, that's the graphic, but that's a live look at the city right now. Up to 500 millimetres is possible over the next 72 hours, with fears of more flash flooding in the coming days. It's the last thing anyone wanted to hear, isn't it? For more, we are joined by Sarah Scully from the Bureau of Meteorology. Sarah, nice to see you this morning. Just tell us a bit about this severe weather warning that's been issued for the New South Wales coastline.
Okay, at the moment the warning extends from Gosford all the way down to Bega and the adjacent land areas. And we're forecasting that heavy rainfall to really start to kick in this afternoon and continue overnight tonight. I think today the heavier rainfall totals will be about the Illawarra, so the Wollongong area. Overnight they've already received between 20 to 30 millimetres. But within this warning area, we're forecasting six hourly rainfall totals between 60 to 100 millimetres and up to 140 millimetres nearer the coast. So we've got flood watches that have been issued as well for that area. And with the dams full, grounds wet and the catchments so saturated, streams, creeks and rivers are expected to respond really quickly to any further rainfall.
Well, that's it. Where are you expecting this flash flooding when, as you sort of just touched on there, I mean, the ground is absolutely drenched and all the dams are full. Where are you sort of keeping an eye on most today?
Well, the flood watch that is current is for the central and for the southern coast, including the Macquarie and the Queanbeyan rivers as well. So that's for minor to moderate flooding at the moment, but we're constantly monitoring all of the river heights and data. So it's important that we, particularly for people that are living on that central and south coast of New South Wales, to stay up to date with the latest warnings that we're issuing.
So when you start looking at these maps and, you know, considering what people have gone through for the past month or more, and then you see this big rain belt coming across again, I mean, how do you respond there in the bomb? Is there another sense of, oh, no, here we go again?
Oh, absolutely. Yes, it's funny, or it's not funny at all. It seems to have just been relentless, which is really quite typical with a La Nina climate driver that we've experienced over this summer. Yeah, you know, our hearts go out to all the people that have been affected. It's not lost on us.
Yeah, and look, I mean, we're sort of focusing at the moment on New South Wales, but of course with Queensland too, you've got this tropical cyclone, which is going to bring hazardous surf to the southeast. How serious is that threat?
Well, we're not expecting the tropical cyclone to impact the mainland. There is the potential for an increase in winds and rain and swell for Norfolk Island and Lord Howe Island, which are our offshore islands. But as well, I wanted to communicate that it isn't just the east coast of New South Wales that is potentially going to be affected over the coming days with severe weather. It's also the inland areas of New South Wales and southern Queensland as well. We're expecting those hit and miss thunderstorms to start to increase today, with the potential for severe thunderstorms with heavy rainfall. And although they're much more sort of hit and miss, there is the potential for really heavy rainfall underneath any of those thunderstorms that do form.
All right. Well, Sarah, I was hoping you'd have a bit better news for us this morning, but appreciate your time. Thank you. Charles.
Thank you.
Right now, you can barely see through the Skycam to Sydney Harbour there. Now, the worst of the rain, even though it has started to fall all the way as far south as Nowra this morning, we are going to see the worst of these falls start to move in throughout the afternoon and particularly tomorrow as well. That's when we're expecting the worst of these falls. For the rest of the country today, though, let's take a look at our major centres right now. Cairns, a top of 32 degrees today, mostly fine and sunny, partly cloudy for Brisbane and 28. Showers for Sydney, 23 will be the high, 20 with a shower or two for Canberra. Melbourne, cloudy and 21 degrees, 17 and partly cloudy for Hobart, partly cloudy for Adelaide as well. Sunny and 29 for Perth, Alice Springs, sunshine and 33 and Darwin. A couple of showers around and some storm action as well. Matt Wright's Top End Safari Camp is where we are waking up this morning. As the sun starts to climb, we are spending a spectacular week in the Northern Territory. And Ali, I know you know just how good it is. I hope that the rest of the country tunes in this morning, because we have got some epic pictures of some of the adventures that we've had of the last 24 hours to share with you, coming up just after 7:30. See you soon.
Oh, good. It's one of the best places in Australia where you are, Tim. Well done. Well, yet another rain bomb is zeroing in, with Sydney and parts of New South Wales in the crosshairs of heavy rain and storms. This is a live look. Well, that's the graphic, but...